Hi, I'm Adam McCarthy and welcome back to SSA Athletics. And in this video, we'll be talking about Kelly Holmes' Athens 2004 800 and 1500 meter performances. If you could smash or lightly tap the subscribe button, the notification button really helps this channel out a lot, improves our message along to other people, and shows that you care. Also, you can check out our Facebook pages, both the training page as well as the general club page, where you can find out more about our athletics club. Also, you can check out the webpage for more information. Okay, let's get on with the video. It's quite funny, really, being a millennial now and watching Kelly Holmes' performances in 2004 and be utterly amazed by them. And yet the kids these days don't even know who she is. But Kelly Holmes is one of the most successful female British athletes of all time. She won the gold medal in the 800 metres and the 1500 metres at the 2004 Olympics. And she did it in a rather interesting way that is very unusual and something that you probably wouldn't recommend to the average athlete. And we at SSA Athletics will explain why. At first, we must explain Maria Mottola and her role in this particular race. Maria Mottola was Kelly Holmes' training partner. And as we look in the start of the 800 metres here, nothing really unusual here. They go off in the pack, fine, nothing really out of the ordinary for the first lap. Now, Maria Mottola was Kelly Holmes' training partner, and she is here in the black. She is here in the black crop top and black shorts. Now watch where she goes in this particular part of the race and look where Kelly Holmes is. Now let's fast forward this to the end of the first lap. So as we see, they're coming round for the 400 metres, 800 metres being two laps, and the pace is super quick, around about 56 seconds for the first lap, which is phenomenal for the women. And as we can see, that Kelly Holmes is roughly around about 4 to 5 seconds off the front, and Maria Mottola is about 4 seconds with possibly Kelly Holmes about a second off of her. Now this is clever race pacing. There's no point going to the very front because the people at the front are now going to go and die slightly. They're going to get overtaken potentially by the people at the back because it's so quick. It's possibly too quick for the first lap. Now, as you can see, Maria Mottola and Kelly Holmes are both known for their kicks. So they will hang in round the pack and they will try and push on. But where they are, for instance, with Kelly Holmes is phenomenally too far at the back, you could argue. Now, if this was an average race, yeah, possibly, but this is Kelly Holmes. So Kelly Holmes knows that she has the biggest kick out of the lot of them. She's the fastest one there, potentially, if it was a straight off sprint. So she knows she can out kick them. So for her to be that far back, it doesn't really matter. But for the average athlete, that'd be too far back. Where you wanted to be is here. Now, the reason why I state this point here is because you're surrounded by the rest of the pack. You're near the front, which means if you can, someone kicks, you can respond to it. But also, you're going to be close to the front as well and potentially overtake. Now, if you're too far back, it gives yourself too much to do. Likewise, if you're in this part of the pack, you also get a nice slipstream effect and you utilize less energy because you're being shielded from the elements. And also, you've got a hair to run off of being the people in front. Now, Maria Mottola is not exactly going to, as Kelly Holmes stated previously, hold her hand and drag her around the track. No, Kelly Holmes is going to stick with her and try and beat her around for that last lap. Maria Mottola is going to try and do everything she can to prevent Kelly Holmes from utilising that phenomenal kick. So as we see, yes, she is going wide around the bend, but she's going wide around herself in order to force Kelly Holmes to go wider so that she utilises more of her energy and waste more energy, therefore potentially wasting that kick off hers.
Come on, Kelly! One more go! Come on, Kelly Holmes! It's goal! Kelly's won the goal for Great Britain! What a race!
Oh, I love that commentary and that finish. It's absolutely awesome. And as she comes along, she looks a little bit confused. Yes, yes, I think you won. Yes, yes. Yeah. There she goes. There she knows. She knows she's won it. That's it, Kelly. Yes, you have won a gold medal. Okay, so that was the 800 metres. Now we're going to go on to the 1500 metres. And as we can see here, same again, same process goes off. Nothing really spectacular happening for the first few laps. So we're going to head off now to the last 400 metres. So as we can see, she's pretty much near the back end again. Possibly not in the right position for the average athlete to then push on or give themselves an opportunity or chance of winning. Yes, she gets a slight push here, which would take a little bit of energy out of her, but she's able to get back into her stride. Down the back straight, she's not really motoring along, but she is eating people up along the way, eating up that ground and taking athletes on. And then when it comes to the final 200, that's when she's pushed. That's when she goes for it. She starts to go through the pack, through the field, and tries to make her way to the front. Slight look the wrong way there, and another look on the correct side. If you're going around the outside, you generally want to look inside if you are going to look. Of course, the best thing to do to see if your opponent's there is actually look at the big screen that is in front of you. Nonetheless, best thing you can possibly do is just not look at all. That is the most streamlined and most fastest way to sprint and run. That's the reason why they recommend or tell you to look at the screen. Now note, I do not know if there was a big screen here at the Athens 2004 Olympics, but I would find it very surprising if there wasn't, especially as all the major events do have a massive screen there because they're utilized for multiple sports like football. So looking up at the scoreboard, for instance, will be able to tell you where the athletes are around you. And as you can see, with about 50 metres to go, no one can catch her, no one's as fast as her, no one's got the same kick as her, and she wins her second gold medal.
She is the double Olympic champion. We've never had one like you before.
When we look at the races she had in the Athens 2004 Olympics, she was fit, she was very fit. Usually she was injured leading into the event, but this year she wasn't. She ran what was tactically really good. It was champagne middle distance running. I hope this video was able to help you. I'm Adam McCarthy of SSA Athletics, and I hope to see you in the next one. Don't forget to subscribe and check out all our socials. Bye!